I want to create a jet-powered mountain bike. Because I think high speeds and a DIY attitude are essential to the soul of mountain biking. Electric bikes have gained immense popularity, and I'm looking to create something to rival that. I want it to be faster, more powerful, and quite frankly, way cooler than a boring old e-bike. Ideally, I'm also hoping to make something that isn't gonna blow up on me.
Oh my god.
This is probably where I should say, don't try this at home. I'll be looking at a few key factors for considering this a success or failure. First, I want my jet bike to be both faster and lighter than its e-bike counterpart. Second, I want there to be an ease of use that requires less physical exertion from the rider, like being able to climb uphill without pedaling. And lastly, we'll be looking at the overall cool factor of the jet bike compared to the e-bike. I want this to be a thrilling and unique riding experience, something that looks and feels way more exciting than an e-bike. Oh, right, and the fourth criteria is that I don't melt any part of my body.
Despite it being quite powerful, the jet engine fits in this little tiny box. And it's not every day you get to unbox a jet engine, so we figured we'd do it here.
Look at that. It's like simultaneously bigger than it looks in the picture, but also smaller than I thought it would be.
The company that makes these, they're in New York. They vet every customer.
A lot of people will use these for like high-end RC jets and RC airplanes and stuff, but they're also like sold to the military and used for military drones and stuff. So basically, everybody that wants to buy one, the company calls them up and you have like this little interview. Like, what are you doing with this thing? Like, are you doing something dangerous? And they kind of like make sure you know how to use it and you're not gonna kill yourself or more importantly, hurt anyone else.
Okay, so in order to push the bike forward, we've got to get our jet engine mounted on the back. There's a few constraints here. Number one, I don't want it to be too close to me. And my butt right here, it's fairly heavy, so we'll need something pretty sturdy to hold it up. There's also a lot of gyroscopic force because this thing spins at like, I don't know how many tens of thousands of RPM, a lot. And so it's gonna have some twisting force here. As the bike turns, it's not gonna wanna twist with it. So we'll need to have something pretty rigid. And then of course, I also need to plumb it with fuel. So somewhere on the bike, I'm thinking in the center here, we'll have the fuel tank here, fuel pump, all the electronics, as well as a throttle on the handlebars to control the speed of the jet engine. So before I get this crazy powerful jet engine mounted on the back of the bike, I need to get it set up and running for the first time ever. What I'm gonna do now is make a bench testing rig, basically attach it to the mounting straps and attach it to a solid surface so we can fire this up.
So we got our jet engine set up here for bench testing.
We've got the fuel pump here. We've got the ECU and our control screen. This is a servo tester, so this will serve as my throttle for the motor.
Okay, with everything primed, we're ready to run our test fire. I'm like, my heart's beating pretty fast. I'm honestly kind of terrified, but I think I'm ready. I'm terrified because I think it's gonna be really loud. Not sure how powerful it's gonna be. Also, this is like a $4,000 jet engine. I don't wanna be the one that ruins it. However, someone's gotta do this, and it's gonna be me. So, earmuffs on.
Stick down.
Oh, that is sound.
Oh my god. I can feel a flow of air. It's like air is just flowing through. Sorry, neighbors. Oh my god.
Successful first test. Now I guess it's time to put it on the bike. Wow, honestly so impressive. What a crazy piece of machinery. Yeah, now we're going to use this seat post rack. It has some side supports that I gotta set up, and then we're gonna put our jet engine right here. That's the plan. Got our first fuel tank holder. Oh yeah, fits the bike. That's good.
I designed and 3D printed these holders myself, so they'd fit perfectly with a fuel tank I scavenged from my diesel heater.
Oh my goodness, I'm so hyped.
That is so sick.
Fuel pump here.
Yeah, that seems
good. Batteries here. Hell yeah. Light on the computer. Oh, we got beep boops.
We have beep boops.
We got beep boops. Oh my god. Oh yes.
think it's time.
Holy. I'm so hyped right now.
Okay, so.
That's really close to my butt. Like, should I tuck my shirt in or something?
Yes, 100% you should tuck your shirt in.
Okay, so now I turn it up to idle and it should say ready. Okay. We have a ready. Brakes are functioning.
Okay.
So nervous. Woo! Okay, ignition. Buffs on now. I can feel it. It's different than on the table because I can feel it.
Don't let go of the bike.
I can feel it in my butt. I can smell it.
At this moment, I had to decide between wearing a helmet or wearing ear protection. And I chose to protect my ears since it was a certainty they would get damaged. But don't be like me, wear a helmet.
It is so loud. That was extremely loud.
It was?
Extremely, extremely loud.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's the last time we'll do that. In the neighborhood.
Yeah.
My adrenaline was so high. When I was like out in the road and the cars were coming, I felt like the cars were going so slow. I was like, why is everything moving
so
slow?
You were going so fast.
And then I realized that it was just my adrenaline just like pumping.
After yesterday's test, I was a little worried about the whole throttle management system and also the fact that the bike would just keep running if I fell off. So, stayed up late last night designing this throttle with kill switch. So we have our range of throttle here, and then this little plug goes on top of this pin. So that's idle. And then when I fall off the bike, it drops down below idle, and the jet shuts down. Good to go. Not gonna go into outer space, hopefully. All right, before we get these dirty, we're gonna do a quick weigh-in. E-bike versus jet bike.
The e-bike weighed in at 56 pounds, 11 ounces.
Oh my God.
Time to see if I successfully made the jet bike lighter than the e-bike.
Oh, 54 pounds and 6 ounces.
Whoa, it's pretty close.
Dang.
That's surprising, actually. I thought it was quite a bit lighter.
We're here at Galbraith Mountain in Bellingham, Washington, Trail Network, where they've recently opened up to e-bike usage. So today we're gonna run a back-to-back series of tests comparing our jet bike to an e-bike.
Our first test is a hill climb test. We have about a 100 meter section here, about a 3% grade. This is your average shuttle road here on Galbraith. You can't quite go full speed up it on an e-bike, but you can get pretty close if you work hard. So it should be a good test to see how the jet bike does on an average climb. Round two, e-bike hill climb. Oh. So I think the time may have actually been quicker because by the time I hit the finish line on the jet bike, I was just really starting to accelerate. Whereas I was just got up to top speed very quickly on this. Yeah. Top speed was definitely slower, definitely a lot more work. Put the stats, the results of the test right here on screen, and we'll see how that went.
All right, for this test, we're gonna do a raw acceleration test. Tom, my friend with the most jacked legs, has volunteered to help us out for this one. He's either gonna beat me or break my chain trying to do it. Mm. I have a theory that he's gonna have a lot more acceleration than me, and then I'm gonna catch up to him about 50 feet down the road. Okay. Let's see how that plays out. What do you think, Tom?
I'm in.
Okay.
Well, how was it when I passed you, Tom?
Smelly and warm.
So worse than passing them on a regular e-bike, because people seem to get pretty upset about that sometimes.
Yes, I believe it'll be slightly worse than a regular e-bike.
My God, this container pours slowly.
Same NASCAR.
For the wheelie test, of course, the e-bike is a wheelie machine.
How will the jet bike fare?
Okay, I think my prediction for the wheelie test is when I try to spool up during the wheelie, since it's above my center of gravity, it's above the center of rotation of the bike, it's just gonna throw my front wheel back to the ground. That's what I think, but we'll see. Oh my God.
They're just aiming down, keeping you down.
Next up was the jump test with the e-bike going first.
Part two of the jump test, jet bike. It's pointy and hot and hard to bail from and very top heavy.
We'll see how that goes.
Okay. Oh my God! Ow!
Fail! What happened?
I rammed this into the back of my leg. Can I just put the seat a bit higher?
Yeah.
Better to bounce my butt off the seat than that wood.
You! How did that feel?
That's it. That's all I'm jumping.
That was a good one. Strong finish.
You have to make sure not to like bend your knees at all, or else you just ram that wood into the back of your thighs. Yeah. Minus points for jumping, jet bike, the diesel fuel spray, and required protective gear is really hot. So is the jet, and sharp, and yeah, not ideal. Gets you up the hill fast. Going down, less fun. Yeah. Point for the e-bike there.
With our tests complete, it was time for one final hurrah on the jet bike.
Our first pro rider on the jet bike.
I gotta get these layers off.
Yeah, you gotta be too warm.
Okay, so in conclusion, let's start with our successes. It did blow my mind that jet engine, diesel fuel and all, this setup was lighter than the e-bike. That being said, pushing yourself forward with air certainly reduces a lot of the weight requirements for a drivetrain. I don't think I could build an internal combustion, mechanically propelled drivetrain that would rival the weight of a modern e-bike. For climbing up hills, to me, the jet bike is clearly more fun than the e-bike. Yes, it's horribly inefficient, but the rumble and the whoosh of air just made pushing the throttle so, so satisfying. Now, when it comes to going downhill, the e-bike, that's our clear winner. I personally love the feel of a heavy bike going downhill over rocks and roots. It makes your suspension feel supple and soft, but that weight on the e-bike, it's down here. The jet bike has a terribly high center of gravity, not to mention the breather valve in the fuel cap. When you're going quickly over rough terrain, the splashing diesel inside the tank seeps out through the breather valve on the cap and just sprays all over you. It was all over my glasses, my overalls. I would say it's a pretty manly cologne though. So that being said, if you're having problems with e-bikes on your local trail network, getting out there on the trails with a jet-powered mountain bike is certain to make the e-bike problem seem like a non-issue.